So this is me, something similar to me. It's saying that I talk something similar to English, but I think it would be enough to convey my ideas. And my ideas, it would be local versus international. Okay? Nothing wrong with local tourism. Nothing wrong with local tourism. But the big league, if we want to be competitive, we have to play in international tourism. Okay? International tourism. Second idea. First, specialized, then generic. I have two powerful reasons for this sentence that we'll discuss in a minute. Chain of value working as a single organization. This is very important. In the same way that when we want to apply revenue management in hotels, all the departments of the enterprise have to work together. Booking, marketing, finance, all together in order to offer a good service. Okay? So in the same way, the chain of value have to work as a single organization. Chain of value, here we have the tourists, here we have the tourist destination, meeting places, travel agencies, ongoing travel agencies, transport companies, incoming travel agencies, chain of value. Okay, the link between the demand and the supply. Oh, I love international tourists. Here are the two reasons. If you want to get the leadership of the chain of value, it's almost impossible in generic tourism. In generic tourism, you have the customer low price orientated. So the winners, the profit, get into the hands of the big intermediaries, the operator, flight sales, group by sales, the biggest search engine, I don't know the name, the most important social networking site. Okay? So it's difficult to get the leadership of the chain of value when we have a customer low price oriented. Apart from that, second idea. In generic tourism, you don't get the skills, the attitude, the contacts in order to build up chain of value. So for that reason, I represent in this figure, first specialized, then generic. Nothing wrong with generic tourism, but if we want to be the leaders in the tourism sector, we have to choose first specialize. We have this man is reading a book, and maybe he is thinking about to have the same experience of the characters of the book. Maybe he want to meet with other readers of this book. Maybe he want to meet with the author of this book. Okay, and if this man is far away, is more and more important to have a chain of value. To have a chain of value in order to get the trust of the customer and to provide services from the beginning to the end of the day. Okay? So, when I talk about specialized tourism, always the same question. Jordi, specialized, we have a small number of tourists specialized. Yes, but we have 100 here, 100 here, 50 here, 20 here, 1,000 here, specialized and international, in all the world, okay? So we have a lot of people, and using long tail theory, we don't go to the biggest social networking site, we don't go to the biggest search engine, we go to specialized meeting places, we go to specialized travel agencies, okay? And using ProAm, the idea of our customers are able to create, communicate, and commercialize the tourism products. Okay, so, and they are around the world talking about something that is important to them, and sooner or later, some of them will say, maybe it's a good idea to meet, together, is an opportunity for a tourism product. So, for instance, members of the chain of value, a case in point. We have this university in Florida where the students learn the Catalan language. Okay, a good way to learn Catalan language is to read Catalan books. Okay, then we have literary tours. A travel agency specialized in literary tours. Then we have book crossing. You know, in order to apply a little bit of gamification in the process. Okay, then you have or public libraries that offer literary tours. Okay? But you see, all these, they don't have a coordination of this chain of value. So my proposal is something like that. You have the members of the chain of value, Here you have the tourists, here you have the hotel or the tourist destination, the chain of value. And thanks to a chain of value portal, you are able to send a customized information, content, commerce, and community to all the members of this chain of value. And they can get the information through different devices, smartphone, tablet, laptop, interactive television, okay? And this is possible because we are using technologies like database and web services. So, tea, no whiskey. 4 minutes. An example, okay? This is WOMATE. WOMATE is a mobile application that allows you to create your itinerary travel. You are with your mobile, and you can get all the information that you need from all the members of the chain of value. If you want to go to this specific city or this specific tourist destination, you know, because they have a special agreement with LinkedIn, if some of your colleagues are in this place as well. Okay? This is the technology that they are using. I don't want to discuss this here, but you can learn more in this course. Okay? You can check it out, this course. Another example, we have a Travel Channel that create documentaries related with tourism, with travel. Then you have Tripology. Tripology is a travel agency, okay? So you have a meeting place and you have a travel agency and they are working together. You are watching a program and at this moment you can contact with the travel agency and they have all the information in order to offer this product to you. This is a chain of value working together. Tripology offers a lot of products related to Spain. Culinary products, bike, this Andalusia, but why don't they sell Catalonian services? We have to make commercial and technological agreements in order to build up a chain of value. Okay, we have the meeting place, we have international specialized tourism, and we have to build up chain of value. Who can do that? Here, you have the answer. My terrestrologists are able to do that. Any of my terrestrologists have the knowledge, the skill, the guts in order to create these technological and commercial agreements. Okay. So, and they make me very happy when they prove that they are able to do that. Now we have the presentation of Gerard. Now we have here we have the presentation of other students, other terrestrologists that are very able to create all these kind of things. So, nothing wrong with local tourism, but the important one is international tourism. We have to bring here tourists from around the world. This is terrestrology, okay? For that reason, this is a science and we are the best in this profession. Because they are able to create, communicate, and commercialize international tourism programs. Then we have one specialized, the generic chain of value working in a single organization. Okay? These powerful ideas, but the most important thing that I have to say today, thank you for your attention.